Welcome to our virtual classroom. Join me for some fun learning.
I am reading. Look at me. Time to put the toys away and listen to what I say. 1, 2, 3. Eyes on me. This is the front of the book. This is the back of the book. And this is the spine. This is the front of the book. It tells you the title of the story, What a Wonderful World. And this is the back of the book. It lets us know it's the end. And this is the spine. And the spine of the book holds the pages together, just like the spine in your back holds your body together. So it's Miss Nicole. Welcome to story time. I'm so super excited about story time because this month is June, and for June, they are highlighting Black Music Month. So what does that mean? Well, over the next few story times, we are going to listen to some Black music. We are going to learn about some Black music. If you know any of the songs, you can join me and we can even sing about some Black music. So the first story that we're going to read is called What a Wonderful World. And I want to show you something right over my head on my bulletin board back here. My small cork board is a worksheet all about this jazz musician. His name was Louis Armstrong, and he lived from 1901 to 1971. He lived and died before I was born. But guess what? His music lives on. The name of our story is What a Wonderful World. And I love this story. So we're going to read it, and then I'm actually going to let you hear the music that goes along with this story by the jazz musician. So they're all different types of musicians, but he's a jazz musician, and his name is Louis Armstrong. And he played, believe it was a trumpet. Yes, he played a trumpet. That's what you see in the picture there. See the trumpet? He played the trumpet, and when he played the trumpet, his cheeks, you need lots of air in your body so you can blow and make music in the trumpet. His cheeks would get so big. Let's hold our breath and let your cheeks puff out. Okay, so if you thought mine looked big, his were huge. And after story time, you can find a trusted adult, a loved one, a parent, a sister, brother, someone who can show you maybe a picture of Louis Armstrong and what his cheeks look like when he blew into the trumpet. So I want to start by saying that Black music didn't start here. We have what's called Old Negro Spirituals. Wow, that's a lot. Old Negro Spirituals. And those were the songs that our enslaved ancestors sang down on the plantation where they were doing lots and lots of hard forced labor. So while they were working to lift their spirits, they sang Negro spirituals, hymns and songs that made them feel better because they were living in such a horrible time for them. And do you know that music can help you to feel better? It can change how you feel. And so they sang these songs to strengthen one another, to strengthen and encourage themselves, to let them know that it wasn't always going to be that bad for them. And I'm so thankful that they had that music to lift them up. I would say right now, Negro spirituals are kind of like gospel music. I don't know if you listen to any gospel music, but Miss Nicole is a big gospel fan. I love gospel music because it just lifts my spirits. It makes me feel encouraged. It makes me feel empowered. It lets me know that everything is going to be all right, even if it doesn't feel okay. So there is a song called Lift Every Voice and Sing. And Miss Nicole shared this story time with us way, way back in 2020, and I was talking about how people were out and people were protesting because there were some wrong things that were going on in lots of different areas, but people were coming together all across the globe. That means not only in America, but maybe wherever you're watching from. So as I'm talking about Black Music Month in America, it's June. And so that's what we're celebrating, but maybe where you're at, it's not June. So I have to remember that people can be watching this, may not be in America, but in America at that time, it was something that was going on globally. So lots of people were aware of what was going on, and they were saying it's not okay in America, and it's not okay where we live, and we're gonna protest, and we have something to say because this needs to stop. So Miss Nicole came on story time, and I shared Lift Every Voice and Sing. And if you go back and watch, it's probably in the representation part of the story time, way back deep in the library, but Lift Every Voice and Sing. So this is what is known in our nation as our anthem. So right now, like Juneteenth is a celebrated holiday that happens in June, and we have an anthem, and it's called Lift Every Voice and Sing. So if you'd like to learn more or listen more to our anthem, please go back and listen to it. We also have the privilege of having two, because we not only have our anthem, we have the American anthem, which is our anthem too, because we are Americans. All right, so let's learn and read about what a wonderful world. Let's see. What do you think makes the world wonderful? Now, remember, I talked about the fact that I live in America and that June is Black Music Month in America, but this story says what a wonderful world. So what is beautiful about the world? Let's think about it. I think what's beautiful about the world is that when there was injustice going on, everybody from all parts of the globe, from all parts of the continents, and were coming together to say, that's not wonderful. That's not wonderful, but we have some things that make our world wonderful. And I think that this musician, this jazz musician, summed it up so beautifully. So I'll start reading. What a wonderful world. And this book is one of my well-loved books. What a wonderful world. It was given to me by a wonderful coworker. You could see she even wrote a dedication to me when she gave me this book. All right, here we go. It was actually to my wonderful family. All right, here we go. I see trees of green, red roses too. So he says he sees trees of green and red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. So to him, roses and trees and animals and sun and sky and water are all part of the wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. The bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Now he's showing us some animals that live in a different part of the country. And I want you to do a picture walk. And if you take a picture walk on this illustration and you walk right over here with your eyes, you will see Louis Armstrong and his trumpet. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. And I think that is one of the beautiful things about the world, that not everyone is the same, that there are so many people that are different, that you can make friends that speak different languages, they eat different foods, they have different holidays, and you can learn all about that. That's called diversity. And then you can include it in the things that you do at home. So just for example, you can include a tradition that you learn from your friend and have it in your, include it in your holiday. Let's say, for example, I love Puerto Rican beans and rice, or Spanish beans and rice. Now that is not my culture, but I can include that in my Thanksgiving dinner by simply saying, hey, you know what? I'm gonna make this dish, or I'm gonna buy it from a restaurant that sells Spanish cuisine, or I can ask my friend, my Spanish friend, to make some beans and rice and bring it to the table for us for Thanksgiving, and we can include that in our celebration. So just like the jazz musician said, it's about the people in the world and the differences in the world. Do you know any friends that speak different than you, that have different traditions than you? When I was a little girl, I had a friend who lived over the fence, and I could always hear her family. They spoke a different language, and I'm not sure if she was German, but I think she was German or Polish. But she spoke English and I spoke English, so we were able to play together. But I would always hear her family, and I could never understand what they were speaking, but she and I loved Cabbage Patch Dolls, and that's what we played together. It says, I see friends shaking hands saying, how do you do? And that is exactly what I had. I had a friend whose family was from a different place in the country, but we seemed to be friends and say, how do you do? And it says, they're really saying, I love you. And it is wonderful to love and to know people that are different than you. If we were all the same, I think it would be kind of boring. That's just me. Imagine if they were all just Miss Nicole's everywhere. Oh my gosh. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. So another one of the things I love about the world are babies. Babies are so sweet. They're learning. They cry a lot. But they're just crying to tell you they need you for something. And as we help them to grow, that's why I love working with you guys, young children, the kind of children that come to watch story time, because there's so much to learn and to understand about the world and to grow into great, kind humans. It's so, so important. And so I love babies. And you know what? My son loves babies. You see him on story time sometimes. He comes, he pops in and helps me do Motivational Movement Monday. And he had a whole week of stories that he read. So we both love babies and puppies. He loves puppies and I love puppies too. But I'm not a pet owner of a puppy. We have Ruby, our red fish, for our virtual classroom pet. All right, so then babies grow up, and then let's see what it says. It says, they'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And so let's talk about that a little bit. Let's talk about learning much more than he'll ever know. So I told you, I shared that Louis Armstrong lived and died before I was even born. And he lived in a world where there was no pandemic. He lived in the world, well, you know what? I think maybe a pandemic happened. So let's use a different example. He lived in a world where there were no cell phones. He lived in a world where there were no distance learning and there was no Zoom. There were no iPads. There were not all of these wonderful, great, there was no microwave. He lived in a different time. So he says that the babies that grow and learn will learn much more than he'll ever know. And if you think about it, little children, like the babies that we see nowadays, they are learning so much more. I know babies that can, well, not babies, but like toddlers who can work iPads. Can you work an iPad? Were you able to turn on story time for yourself? Are you able to work your TV remote? That's because technology is a big part of our world. And for almost a year, we were all home and we were all using different types of devices to connect with each other. So there's a lot more technology. Louis Armstrong lived in a world where he couldn't imagine all the technological advances. That's a tongue twister, but there are all these advances in technology that he could not have imagined. He says again, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And the illustrator again put Louis Armstrong. So this illustrator, who is the person who drew the pictures, is imagining this is a time where Louis Armstrong was alive, and he's actually using the Louis Armstrong puppet that is holding his famous trombone. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And I just want to talk, give you something else about this story. One more idea as we look at the pictures. That in the beginning, did you see that everybody was working together on something? They're making all types of signs, and I see the trees that they're making. I see someone making another sign and stars. I actually see someone with the Louis Armstrong puppet, because this story is them doing a puppet show of all of the things that he's saying. See, there are the trees and the roses, and you see the people popping up and holding them. So this story is supposed to be about them doing a puppet show. So as we close this story time, I am going to cue up What a Wonderful World and let you listen to it as we end story time. Come back, because I have another story that I want to share with you. And we're going to go from jazz music to rap music. Are you ready to go with me? And let me also show you Charlie Parker. Charlie Parker is another musician who played bebop. So this is another story all about Charlie Parker, who played bebop. And Charlie Parker's bebop was a little different. It was all about sounds, and it was called like scatting. So first let's listen to Louis Armstrong, and then we'll talk about Charlie Parker and bebop and scatting. All right, here we go. Let's find Louis Armstrong. Are you ready to listen with me? Thank you for joining me.
Thank you for joining me. See you next time. And remember, you are the you in unique.